etiquettes for being online.
What do we mean by the term etiquette? According to Cambridge Dictionary, etiquette means the set of rules or customs that control accepted behavior in particular social groups or social situations. Etiquette helps us to show respect and consideration to others and make others glad that we are with them. Without proper manners and etiquette, the customs of the polite society would disappear and we will act more like animals and less like people. Online etiquette means the correct or acceptable way of communication or behaving on the internet. Sometimes this term online etiquette is known as netiquette. Netiquette is a combination of the words network and etiquette and is defined as a set of rules for acceptable online behavior, not only to culture but also to the status and image. Presenter must arrive 5 to 10 minutes earlier than the scheduled time. Participants are also expected to arrive a few minutes before or at most at the start time. If you are late, a simple apology to the attendees is always appreciated. Have a proper name and photo. If your video is off or using some program which doesn't show your video, then make sure your username and photo are appropriate. Greet everyone. Greeting the people isn't only polite, but it establishes a rapport. It is important to greet everyone with the same degree of kindness. A simple, "Hi, how are you?" or even a smile is enough. However, adding more could make them remember you and view you as a friendly and pleasant. Be respectful and polite to presenter and participants. It doesn't matter if you are meeting through online. Each interaction needs to be professional. Good manners are always appreciated. Remember that virtual participants cannot see body language, so speakers need to be mindful of how attitudes come across without visual cues. Be kind and courteous. It's just as important to show good manners online as it always has been. Never flame or rant in public forum. Show respect for the opinion of others, even if you don't agree. Avoid gossiping or saying anything negative about others. Never say anything negative about your organization, your boss, or your employees. Dress appropriately. Looking confident encourages confidence in your presentation. Participant and presenter must display an overall image of a neutral and blended individual. Do not wear an outfit which have graphic prints or gaudy colors or t-shirt having slogans, etc. Be professional and courteous by dressing appropriately. Do not wear pajamas, knickers, banyans, etc. Good hygiene is also a must. Comb your hair, trim your beard as well. Some participants wear a formal shirt but they are in knickers, so avoid such embarrassing moments. Proper dressing will help you stay focused and in work mode even if you are away at home. Although, just because there is no rule for online class or webinar dressing, it doesn't mean that one show up in a hoodie or sweatpants, etc. In fact, studies have shown that the first thing that people notice about others is their appearance. Don't wear a three-piece suit, but if you dress smartly, it reflects your enthusiasm into your work. When you dress in long wear or knickers or pajamas, people may think that you are a lazy person. Avoid nervous habits. Nervous habits are displayed in uncomfortable situations and make us look weak. These are due to insecurity that are displayed every day. Whether it's pulling on shirt collar, avoiding eye contact, or something else. The problem with nervous habits is that they show that you are not confident in what you are doing or saying. Types of nervous habits are lack of eye contact. When you are nervous, it's common to avoid eye contact. Eye contact is intimate, and your body wants to avoid any kind of intimacy when it's anxious. then how to correct it? When you talk, remind to establish eye contact. Too much is unnatural and signals aggression. So, regularly try to re-establish eye contact for a short time. Lip biting. Nervousness can cause dry mouth, which in turn can subconsciously cause you to lick your lips, and the tension in your face can cause you to bite them. Then how to correct it? Before an important conversation or meeting, try to drink a significant amount of water, but not so much that you would be uncomfortable without a bathroom break. If it's appropriate, have a liquid ready during the conversation too. Crossed arms. This is a universal sign of discomfort and often means we are struggling to accept that what the other person is communicating. Nail biting or nail picking. This is a universal sign of stress. If you are feeling insecure, you might find yourself doing it in the presence of others. Then how to correct it? Try to keep your hands away from each other and away from your mouth. Be aware of your surroundings. Background should be neutral. The room which you are planning to use as a virtual classroom or meeting room should have a neutral or visually pleasing background. This can be a plain wall and a neat room. Plain curtains behind you are also acceptable. Use white or light colored walls and tables in your meeting spaces to brighten up the room with reflected light. White surfaces reflect light, whereas black surfaces absorb it. Using a lot of white or bright surfaces and walls in your conference room will brighten up the space by bouncing light around. No beds in the background. Make sure your background is professional and work appropriate. This means there should be no beds in the background. Some of us convert our living room or bedroom into our new workspace. Remember, no one wants to see your messy house or the sleeping area in the background during an important conversation. Remember, your background on a virtual meeting is just as important as how you can present yourself during an in-person meeting. No messy rooms or open closets. Do you like a perfectly clean and organized room or a messy room? Or would you rather spend your time in a room cluttered with objects, souvenirs, books, artwork, and items that make up your daily life? Organized rooms show perfection in your life. Messiness has been viewed as a sign of laziness. Cleanliness and organized things are presented as a sign of and path to success. No dirty cloths in the corner. People won't take you seriously when there's a pile of dirty cloths in the corner behind you. So make sure that there isn't a pile of dirty dishes or laundry in your background. What does not suitable for work mean? Not suitable for work or not safe for work is an internet term used in email subject lines, online classroom, webinars, and other online media. It is mean to warn a potential viewer that the content is not suitable for viewing in a work environment or near children, usually because of indecent or other explicit content. Also, keep your desktop clean. The image on your desktop should be safe for work, not offensive, and be appropriate for showing to all participants. No wildly running of children through the house. During online classroom or conference, if children are running, shouting, knocking, and hammering, then you and your participant will be distracted. So no such acts through the house during online period. Do not sleep. During online class, webinar, conference, some participants sleep while their camera is on. Sleeping on a professional conference or webinar or video conferencing is pretty bad. So avoid it. Put your mobile away. One should keep his or her phone silenced during online classroom, webinar, meeting so that it doesn't interrupt. Don't get distracted by your phone or distract other participants by the ringing sound of your phone. It's just a plain rude. Inform others at home that you are online. Try to keep background noise to a minimum during an online meeting. Participants will struggle to hear important conversation because of background noise. So, inform others at home that you are online and make sure others around you know that you are working online so they respect your space. Mute your microphone when not talking. When you are not talking, it's best to mute your microphone. By doing this, other participants will not hear unavoidable background noise and they will not be disturbed. If you are working from home or from some other public place, then distracting sound is inevitable. It is encouraged to find an optimal location in your home or some other place for a virtual meeting. Frame the camera correctly. Camera to be in right position. The camera should be set in such a way that the front portion of the body be in the middle and try to look directly into the lens. Face shouldn't be too high or too low. In this way, the other participant also feel personally addressed. Camera should be at face level. It should be 30 inches or one arm distance from you. Try to look directly at camera, which creates a stronger connection and will show your confidence. Also, do not walk around with your camera. When you do this, you must turn off the camera. Otherwise, everyone is going to get very dizzy. Look at camera, not screen, when talking. While looking at someone's face is perfectly natural, looking straight at camera and speaking takes some practice. To give the appearance that you are speaking at eye level to participants, and if you don't want to show off a double chin, prop your laptop or mobile device or camera at your eye level. Proper lightening in the room. Dimly lit rooms feel unprofessional. Ensure your desk has a strong but soft light that can illuminate your face during online class or webinar or video conference. According to daylight conditions, create uniform lightening on your face. Light source should be originating from somewhere in the room, and that is behind webcam, and shining light on your face is essential. Light source should not be behind the presenter or participants. Straight on lightening is best for video conference. So try to sit facing a light source. This ensures your face is well illuminated and clearly visible. Using natural light from the window to fill in the sides also creates pleasing, accurate skin tones in the camera and renders accurate colors. When there is not enough light or too much light or a light is pointed in the wrong direction, it can cause cameras to render a low quality image. A lot of window light is useful in creating a well-lit professional setting. Stay seated and stay present. It may be tempting to check your inbox or carry on side conversation during a dull moment in a meeting or in a classroom, but don't do it. Use attitude to body language. Sit up straight. Don't make a big extraneous movements and don't let your eyes wander too much. No eating of food. Try to eat a snack before your virtual meeting or classroom or webinar. No one wants to see stuff in your mouth while discussing important matters. Not only is it distracting to others, you won't be able to focus on the task at hand because you will be worrying about dropping crumbs all over your laptop or mobile. Speak clearly. When you are talking, don't forget to unmute your microphone. Make sure to speak clearly and slowly enough for everyone to follow. Also, try not to talk over anyone else. Remember that sound quality is very important in these online medium. Although there may be unavoidable lags due to slower connection, try to ensure no one speaks over anyone else. Glitching audio problem may arise due to lagging internet speeds. So deliberately add pauses into your speech after finishing a point. Enunciate your words and speak slowly during online meetings. Home internet connection quality can vary, as does the reliability of devices. Keep in mind that there is often a minor delay when someone talks, so pause after asking a question or listening to someone's response. Avoid crosstalk. It is a generally accepted practice to avoid crosstalk, which is addressing a share at another person rather than the group. When shares are directed to the group, everyone can benefit from the message being forwarded, and no individual in the group is singled out. Be cognizant of other languages and cultures. In some cases, you might also find yourself meeting with people of different backgrounds and cultures. So be aware of their language and customs to the best of your ability before meeting. Keep participants focused with visuals and presentations. A successful virtual conference or meeting involving virtual attendees depends on good planning. Online presentations keep participants focused with visuals. Ensure that there is something on the screen to help attendees know the subject. Vary the tone of your voice. In online classroom or meetings, voice plays a key role. Vary the tone of your voice. Don't try to sound like a DJ or a voiceover actor. Put a little energy to voice and modulate volume, pitch, or pace when needed. Avoid quick movements, which make it difficult for cameras and microphones to keep up with you. Quick movement may appear jumpy or choppy to others. Basics of presentation design. Whether you use PowerPoint or Keynote, the basic rule of presentation is especially important in web conferences. As little text as possible on a slide. Clear fonts. Clearly visualize structuring of the outline labels. Numbered slides. Quiet or simple background. No complex animations. Resting mouse pointer. Transition slides are distracting. Only required programs to be opened. Do not open unnecessary programs, documents, and presentations. Do not check email. Chatting or scrolling social media is prohibited. Provide copies of essential documents. If you reference any important documents during your online class or meeting, send those items to meeting participants before or during the meeting so they can have them for the reference. Screen sharing. Before sharing the screen, shut down any program that you aren't using and close document that won't be used in the classroom or webinar or meeting. Avoid indecent pictures or unedited videos while sharing your screen. Be prepared for technical difficulties. Choose the right technology with which you and your remote participants are familiar. Any eventuality may arise, so make sure everything is working properly. Make sure the net connection is stable. Make a backup plan. Leave with a goodbye. Always sign off from a virtual classroom or webinar or meeting or conference with a formal goodbye for attending. It makes a difference and doesn't cost you anything. While preparing this video, we had taken the help of different materials displayed on the screen, and we are thankful to them. In this video, we have discussed about etiquettes for being online. If you have any doubt or want any clarification, then you can contact through the mail shown on the screen. For other videos, you can visit the web address as shown on the screen. Thank you.